Hello everyone, I am here at Chirag, Faculty of Diploma Computer in Dr. Subhash Technical Campus. Welcome to Lecture 4 of Unit 1, Introduction to Mobile Computing. In Lecture 4, today we discussed the basic concept of cell, cluster, GSM architecture, how GSM architecture works, and GSM service. Cell is the area where wireless transmission between mobile phone and base station takes place is called a cell. Transmission of data occur between mobile phone and base station. Mobile phone is responsible for users' data transmission and reception. A base station is capable to handle server call of subscriber. There are two types of link, downlink and uplink. Transmission of user data from base station to mobile phone is called downlink. Transmission of data from mobile phone to base station is called uplink. Single cell system is quite limited. The farther subscriber from base station, lower the quality of radio link. If the subscriber leaves the supply area of cell, no more communication is possible. To overcome this limitation, cellular systems were introduced. In figure, we can see the shape of cell is hexagon. Next topic, cluster. Cluster is a group of cell. No channel are used in a cluster. The typical cluster contain 4, 7, 12 and 21 cells. The large number of cell in a cluster, greater the distance between cell sharing frequency. The number of cell in a cluster must be determined so that cluster can be repeatedly continuous within the area of operator. The large number of cell in the cluster, greater the distance between cell sharing same frequency, they reduce the interference. The same frequency are used again in other cluster. The total number of channel per cell depend on number of available channel and type of cluster used. In figure, we can see the cluster which contain 7 cell. Another concept in cluster is frequency reuse. A small number of radio channel frequency are available in mobile systems, so need of reuse of radio channel to carry more than one conversation at a time is must. So frequency reuse required. The concept of frequency reuse is assigning to each cell a group of radio channel used within small area. Cell are assigned channel different from neighboring cell. Same group of channel is used in different cells that are far enough from each other so that their frequency do not interference. So these are basic concept of cell and cluster. Next topic is GSM architecture. In figure we can see the architecture of GSM architecture. In figure there are SIM, BTS, BSC, HLR, VLR, MSC, EIR, AUC, PSTN, ISDN. There are many abbreviations used in GSM architecture. First we study this abbreviation full form. ME means mobile equipment, SIM, subscriber identity module, MSC, mobile switching center, HLR, home location register, AUC, authentication center, ISDN, Integrated Service Digital Network, BTS, Base Transceiver Station, BSC, Base Station Controller, EIR, Equipment Identity Register, VLR, Visitor Location Register, PSTN, Public Switch Telephone Network. GSM architecture can be divided into four main parts. First, the mobile station. Mobile station consists of ME means mobile equipment and SIM means subscriber identity module. ME is a physical terminal such as telephone or portable wireless device. It includes radio transceiver, digital signal processor, and SIM. The SIM is responsible for storing the subscriber identification number, contact list, encryption keys, etc. SIM is detachable so user can retain his or her information after switching handset. Next, the base station subsystem. BSS consists of BSC and one or more BTS. Each BTS defines single cell and include radio antenna, radio transceiver, and a link to BSC. BSC is responsible for reserving or radio frequency, manage handoff of mobile unit from one cell to another within BSS, control paging. It connects mobile station and NNS. It is in charge of transmission and reception, perform many functions like radio resource control, frequency hopping, digital signal processing. BSS can be divided into two parts, BTS. BTS is a set of transceiver to talk to MS. One BTS can cover more than one cell. Its transmitting power defines the size of cell. BTS is connected to BSC via ABC interface with a transmission rate of 2 Mbps. Second part of BSS is BSC. BSC controls several BTS. BSC manages channel allocation and handover of calls from one BTS to another. BSC is connected to MSC via a interface. BSC has a database for all its BTS. Third part is the operation and support subsystem OSS. The OSS is an element within the overall GSM network architecture that is connected to component of NSS and the BSC. It is used to control and monitor overall GSM network, and it is used to control the traffic load of BSS. And last main part of GSM architecture is the network and switching subsystem. NSS, which is managed communication between mobile user and other user. It also includes database needed to store information about subscriber and to manage their mobility. NSS has following main component. First, MSC. It is the central component of NSS. The MSC performs switching function of the network. It also provides connection to other network. MSC performs following main function: call setup, supervision and release, digit collection and translation, call routing, billing information collection, mobility management like registration, location upgrade, paging and altering, management of radio resources during a call, echo cancellation, manage connection to BSS, other MSC and ISDN, integration of appropriate registers. The Gateway Mobile Service Switching Center, GMSC. The GMSC has an additional connection to other fixed networks such as PSTN and ISDN. It is in charge of routing call from fixed network to GSM user. Home location register, a database in GSM system that store information of user belong to covering area of MSC. It also store current location of this user and service to which they have access. Service registration details, mobile terminal characteristics, location of user correspond to SS7 address of visitor location register. Next, database is visitor location register. Contain information from a user's HLR to provide subscribe service to visiting user. When a user enters the covering area of new MSC, the VLR associate to this MSC will request information of this user from its HLR. There is no VLR per MSC. There is one VLR per MSC. VLR also have information about features, currently activated, temporary mobile station, identity, and current location information about mobile. Authentication center. Associated with HLR, it contains authentication parameters that are used on initial location registration, subsequent location updates, and on each call setup request. Authentication is a process to verify user SIM. Secret data and verification algorithm are stored in AUC. Authentication and radio channel encryption can be carried out within visited network. Next, database is EIR, Equipment Identity Register. It is the database of all IMEIs, store information about equipment. It contains list of all valid terminal EIR allow for binding calls from stolen terminals. So these are the four main parts of GSM architecture. Next topic is GSM services. GSM services operator, cellular services operator are providing many value-added services. Basically, three categories of service are provided by cellular operator. Teleservices, which include voice service, SMS, teletext, etc. Second, barrier service, which include data services. Third, supplementary service, which is include call forwarding, call bearing, and call waiting. First is voice service. Most important teleservice is telephony. Here speech communication take place. Cellular operator must provide good voice quality for customer. Second service provided by GSM is SMS, short messaging service, used to convey short message like news, jokes. A message of maximum of 160 character can be sent. If mobile is powered off, message is stored with SMS cell broadcast. A message of maximum 93 character can be broadcast to all mobiles in certain area. Third service is MMS, multimedia messaging services. Message includes multimedia objects like image, audio, video, rich text. Its main standardization effort is done by 3GPP, 3GPP2. It has been designed to work with all mobile packet data service such as GPRS. Next service is LBS, location-based service. It provides location-specific information to mobile user moving from location to location. There are many types of LBS. Location-based information provide location of particular place to user. It can provide list of shopping malls, restaurant near to mobile user. It can also alert mobile user to remind purchase of specific terms whenever she is closer to area which is closer to vendor of such item. And next, location-based billing. Through this, user can establish personal zones such as home work zone and work zone. With this, user can enjoy flat rate calling at home, special rate calling at other design zone. LBS also include location-based emergency service, location-based tracking. And other is VAS, value-added service. All service beyond standard voice call and fax transmission. Mobile VAS service can be mainly categorized into three category: consumer VAS, network VAS, and last, enterprise VAS. Thank you for watching lecture of introduction to mobile computing. Watch more video, like our YouTube channel and subscribe and share. Thank you for watching.